Hi everyone, what's up? It's Joshua here with Alternative Brewing. And today we're here to check out the Eureka Mignon Classico coffee grinder. Now the Eureka Classico joins the Mignon range as the ideal espresso grinder and has the overall appearance and functions that are very similar to the Eureka Mignon E, with those options of both manual and timed grinding. Now the Eureka Mignon range are well-known grinders for their robust, full metal body construction and solid grinding performance, hailing from that Italian heritage that draws upon the knowledge and experience at espresso coffee in general. Now, the Eureka Classico comes in several different colors, including this black version you see here. And if you like the look of the Mignon Classico, you can shop that full range by following this link up above and stay watching to find out more of the specs that make the Classico a great grinder for your home espresso setup. Starting from the top, the capacity to the Classico's hopper is 300 grams, and a shutoff valve to the hopper allows you to close it off to remove those beans without a mess, keeping them fresh for longer. And it also works well enough too if you are wanting to single dose your coffee one dose at a time, having those burrs turning before you open the chute to grind out. And a small feature that often goes unnoticed is the rubber seal that holds the hopper in place on top of the grinder nice and secure. The Eureka Mignon Classico uses 50mm stainless steel flat burrs powered by 1350 RPMs from the motor. This helps produce efficient grinding speeds of around 2 grams a second. And the look of the grinds are considerably even and well distributed, and the grinds do always find their way into the basket without any excessive clumping or flying off the sides. The Eureka Classico is a stepless grinder, and this means you have full movement of that grind dial all the way fine to all the way coarse without any clicks or notches of the grind settings that you're locked into. Now, that adjustment dial found on the corner of the grinder's body is super simple to access and effortless to turn to adjust to grind sizes. And Eureka implemented on all their Mignon grinders that adjustment mechanism that changes the bottom burrs rather than changing the top burrs. And this avoids using a collar adjustment mechanism that tends to become stiff and rigid from becoming blocked and choked with grind particles or oils around the neck. And the Classico's adjustment is contained within the grinder's body. And this makes turning that dial on the Classico really easy to do. Just be sure though, those burrs are spinning as you adjust the grind size finer to ensure there are no beans stuck between the burrs. And the Eureka Classico, being an espresso grinder, will comfortably grind for any espresso machine. It will produce grinds used for some filter brewing too. And some of the settings I have tried are espresso grinds at various settings, as well as mocha pot and a fine AeroPress and pour over grind as well. But it does eventually become harder to achieve a good consistency from a coarser grind setting. To begin using the Eureka Classico, once the grinder is turned on, you activate the grinding operation by pressing the button set at the back of the portafilter forks. Now, you're given two modes of grinding with the Classico. Found next to that on and off button are either a manual mode with the button pressed out, and this will operate the grinder so long as you have that activation button pressed in, and it will switch off the moment you release it. The second option is to press that mode button in, which is your timed option, and using the timer knob next to that, turn it one way will increase the automatic amount of time that the grinder grinds for, and then the other way will reduce the time, similar to a toaster's function, I guess. Although if you're using this for dosing coffee into your basket, you will want to use some scales in order to achieve a consistent result. It's also important to note that if you adjust the grind size, you'll also need to adjust the time to maintain that consistent dose. Taking a look at grinding hands-free, it is possible, but these aren't adjustable portafilter forks, so it may not apply to all portafilters. And taking a look at retention and blockages, which do occur on most grinders, especially at these finer settings, the Eureka Mignon range do better than expected, with a short and narrow grinding chute for coffee to travel down and a fantastic declumper at the top of the chute that works to make sure those grinds are always broken up efficiently and then come out nice and fluffy. And then to follow a cleaning schedule on your Classico grinder requires a Phillips head screwdriver with access to the burrs behind one screw at the back, and then remove three more to get into the burr chamber. Give this chamber a gentle brush out and a thorough vacuum to get the job done quickly and remove any dust or grind buildup around the grinder so it continues to perform at its best for years to come. and that's the Eureka Mignon Classico coffee grinder for you. It's a stock standard grinder for features, but it does have that outstanding quality in its manufacturing that provides reliable and consistent performance for espresso brewing. So if you have any questions on the Classico grinder, throw them in the comment section down below and we'll get straight back to you. Don't forget to hit that little bell icon on your screen, and then that way you stay notified when we bring out new videos just like this every week. If you've enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.